Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Rainbow Skies. Okay, so we're still in the town of Mokimfu, and basically what we're going to do today is just basically try and explore around the town and talk to as many people as possible, see if we have any new quests to try and pick up. So, let's see, it's 2:42, so the first thing I want to do is actually go over here and check out the Wheel of Fortune thing, Wheel of Luck, actually. Just because it's now going to be soon to change days and I want to use up today's chances. As you can see, I've still got one S prize to find for battle, for bet level 1. I think I can go to 2, yes I can, so let's do that. Hopefully Whip will win some nice prizes. I kind of want that gold star, that's the best prize of all, so we've got a C prize, it's probably not going to be great. Equipment license 4. It's not too bad.
Thank you.
Could come in handy if I do choose to eventually start using monsters in my team. Let's go again actually. I will probably keep continuing with bet level 1 off camera. Try and pick up that last S prize. Another C. Guess it's another equipment license 4. Okay. Can always sell them if I don't need them. Right, we've got another 2 turns to go, so let's do another 200. Oh, so close. Alright, according to that, the C prize underneath the equipment license 4 is flashing, so let's. Must be a new one. Ah, defense buff. Okay, I think I've got 3 of those now. They might come in handy. Let's just use up our last turn of the day. Come on, gold star. Give me a nice prize. Ain't gonna happen. Nope, too far away. So we've got a B prize. What are you gonna give us? A mighty flask. Come on. Could I give me better prizes than that? Alright. So yeah, as you can see, I've still got one S prize to find on bet level 1. Not sure what it's gonna be. I have been playing it as much as possible since I've unlocked it. I think there is a reward, an actual award if you get something like either 100 or 200 prizes from grade B or higher. So we're getting there. It'll probably still take a bit of time. But okay, we've done our chance for today. As I say, I did it right off the bat there just because it's now going to be hitting time to change into a new day soon, and that'll give us another turn. So let's just jump into here just now. I don't think I need to heal up, but I want to just double check there's no books or anything that are new. Oh, there is new books. Ranged magic level 6, self-propelled something. I don't really want to buy it right now because I want to try and keep any money in case I can get new gear. Drain magic volume 4, greedy thief. Expert. I think I'm okay to actually use them right now. I think I've done the battles at the monster arena enough to actually be able to use them. Protective magic 2 gives us magnet 1. We've got weakened shield. Protects against weakened and armor protection. Prevents monsters from removing allies' armor. That's what I want. I'm definitely going to buy 3 of them. I do not care. I'm buying them because there is a few fights there that, you know, remember the ghosts that kept using the skill to try and remove your armor? It was such a pain. So these are definitely getting used and equipped. Weakened. I could probably use weakened as well, to be honest with you. I'm going to buy a couple of these as well. Anything else? I'm not bothered about level blessing. First blow, quadruple damage when you land the first blow in battle. It might be worth using, but at the moment, again, I want to constantly use my points for keeping the armor and all that stuff on. Reserve magic we've already done before. I don't really need to worry about these ones just now. I will obviously spend a bit of time going through all my skills, but I'm definitely glad I came in here to check all that out. So Let's see, I'm going to put on this accessory bag just to clear out space. And again, I did find a treasure map and a treasure chest. I think it was near this island. And it is for the land of Irelia, so I will try and find that at some point. Okay, so I'm going to start putting these on everybody. Protection armor. Weakened. That's all that I bought, so I'm just going to equip these just now, if possible. Skill points left is 3, so let's see. Armor protection's already equipped, and weakened protection's already equipped, because I had the points to do it. I didn't have enough points for that. Negative conditions last for a shorter period. I can get rid of magic attack. Put on... Oops, I actually want this off. Put this on. I still need a couple of points for that, but I don't think there's anything else that I'd want to take off right now. Because I want to keep myself in defense mode at the start of battle. I want to keep myself from being bound, so I'll probably have to wait a little bit longer. That's not going to be any good to me just now. I think I'm good just now. As long as I've got armor protection on, I'm fine. And it's pretty much the same deal with Damien. I don't really think there's anything else that I can take off at the moment. Normal attacks, I could probably keep, I kind of like Damien having that skill to be honest with you, but that seems like okay just now. As I'm leveling up, obviously I'll gain more skill points to use and I'll probably equip them on, but definitely that armor protection is definitely worth having. Okay, so we've done him, accessories, materials, and healer as normal. Right, let's see. I do have the key for that, so let's use item. Again, we did find that harbour key and a little bag in this little corner right next to the town, so if you're struggling to find it, that's exactly where it is. Alright, let's talk to... Was that Dago or Dega? I do not know. Let's talk to him anyway. There's nothing wrong with leading a seafarer's life. New quest, Monster Hunt 10 received, okay. There's nothing wrong with daydreaming, to be honest with you. Well, you're not locked anymore, I've unlocked the door for you. Ooh, hope it's a good monster. Well, I think we're actually good monster hunters. We've defeated, what, 9 of them so far? And and pretty much all of them are at 100% now because I've been constantly fighting them over and over. I do need to go back to the future and finish off 2 of them. Ooze worm, okay. So it's near the Osher Swamp. On holy day, fair enough. But I don't know why it makes it special. Ah, okay. It's interesting. I know with Beast Day it was it takes health away from monsters, a little bit of it anyway. Okay, so we're talking round about 12-ish maybe, and obviously we've got to fill up our hunger meter apparently, because it says you were feeling quite full. Fair enough, we'll need to eventually try and track that down. How can you not remember what it's like? Not really. It has long legs, very long legs, I think. Very, very long legs. I wonder if it's one of those... is it Stilbanes or something like that? They had very long legs. Yeah, that's a very big spider, you never know. Ooh, hate spiders. Alright, quest updated. Locate the ooze worm at the Osher Swamp and defeat it. Ashley knows the details. Return to Digoa or Doga, I do not know, when you're finished. Fair enough. We'll need to look into Monster Hunt 10 at some point. Okay. So, spoke to you. Let's see. Nothing else around here. Got the boat rental guy. That's fine. Have I not been there before? That's weird. Unless that bit was blocked off all the way around. Or maybe that's what it is. Maybe I haven't been into the dust temple area. That's fine. We'll need to eventually try and slot there. Check that out. Right, let's get into the other shops. And it just said Mokimfu was fully explored there. So that's good. We've got 100% in that area. Let's check the armor shop first. See if we've got any. Yes, we have. This is flashing. So we've got dragon scale armor. HP's plus 20,000. But obviously compared to what we're wearing just now, it's an increase of 12,000. That's actually pretty good. Definitely worth it, I would say. I'm going to lose a day's shield. Got a couple more slots, that's fine. I can always put on day's shield again. So buy that. We actually have headgear as well at the same time. It's going to boost up our speed more than anything, but that's definitely worth it because I kind of feel all the enemies at the current stage right now are actually getting all turns before me. And again, first defense, I'm not too worried about because we already have it as a passive skill. Got more slots again, so we're buying that. I should have enough money for it all, to be honest with you. Lane's got tribal clothing. Again, it's going to give us more HP, so it's definitely worth it. It's got a little bit more strength. It'll get rid of Wily Warrior, and again, has more items, item slots, so we'll buy that for him. And he's got a tribal mask. Oh, it's got 88 plus defense. That's totally worth it on that alone. I'm going to lose the daredevil skill, but I don't really mind. Seems like all our gear is going to have more slots. May have to spend a bit of time upgrading all this off camera. Dress of shields, again, it's going to boost up her HP. It's definitely worth it for Ashley because she's struggling at the moment. She's got 17 more defense than what I'm currently wearing, but that's fine as well. Got more slots. Okay, I'll buy that. She's got gold antlers. Sadly, it's not get any single little boosts at the moment. It's got a bit of speed on it, but it's not much. I'm gonna lose my day's shield, which is kind of the thing that's been worrying me about switching her headgear at the moment, because the amount of enemies that hit you with days, and she's quite useful when she's not getting inflicted with it. But we'll buy it anyway. I may have to decide whether I'm going to put that on or not. Starcatcher socks is plus 374 health. It's got a bit of increase in defense. That's got a bit more HP boost, so I'm probably going to be using that on Damien, but I'll buy both of them. I should have enough money to buy whatever I need, I think. Golden Sundial. It's got a speed boost. Seafarer's Watch has got a bigger speed boost, so I'll buy one of them just now. It's got more slots anyway, so it's definitely Sea Watch I might put on. Is there nothing for Ashley? Okay, she can put on them as well. I'll buy one more of them and probably give it to Ashley. Might come in handy. Might actually need to buy a couple of them and just make both of them wear two of them each, probably. And these items are for beasts again, but I'm just gonna use them just so it fills up new item slots on my item list, because I think there is a an award for getting a certain amount of that complete as well. Like weapon shop, see if we get any new weapons. Doesn't seem like it, that's a shame. Could have done with some new weapons as well. Again, those are for beasts, but I'll just buy them anyway. Veteran's belt, we'll buy that. We'll buy the two of them, seeing as we have enough money. We've still got 43,000. It's not too bad. Okay, accessories. Glob of goodness. That's for everybody can wear that. Okay, it's got a bit of slots on it, but it's not ideal, I don't think. I'll buy one of them. Finger crown for beasts and moonshine ring for beasts, buy that. Windwalker medal, buy that. And a golden hair clip, we'll buy one of them. Okay, we're still alright with money. So we're not too bad. So we've got new passive skills and all that there. Got a couple of new items. We've got the fern key for that. So that's fine. Okay, I think we're sort of good now. Right, let's see what else we've got here. I want to quickly go to the item guy before it switches over days and he's not available. It will take the portal crystal because obviously we need it. What else we've got? A strong health potion. I'll buy one. Never know when I might need one of them. Let's see. Anti-weakness potion, not bothered with. That converts red into blue. I've got plenty of blue anyway. Okay. So you're selling skill stones now, but I kind of feel like I don't want to get into all that, because if I start buying them too frequent, then eventually it's going to start costing a fortune to actually get them. I probably will need to buy more bags for probably items and food and all that at some point. And we've got a looped line rod, so we're going to buy that so we can at least start fishing in this area. So I've got 30,000 rainbow coins roughly left.
Thank you.
A new portal has been unlocked, that's fine. Still got one hidden treasure to find in this area. I just want to very quickly, oops, I didn't mean to go in there. I want to very quickly actually try and see if I can find this. It's not a very big town, so a chicken leg, okay. Alright, at least we've found that. Okay, so I think we've been in all the little stores, so let's talk with you. Well, what about Ashley? New side quest, the gambler received. Yeah, why can't she join us? She's part of our team. Men's talk. That's not very nice. Well, we're not doing too bad in the lottery. I don't think I've got a winning strategy. I just basically press a button and hope to God that I win something decent. Witch's skirt. Well, if I was going to win a witch's skirt, why wouldn't we keep it for ourselves? Well, I'd probably try and at least go for category S. I mean, category A prizes aren't too bad, but S is obviously the better one. Well, if it's so low, then why would we give you the witch's skirt? Because if it's something that Ashley could wear, I'd rather give it to her. Well, that's what you get for gambling, because it's not always a win-win situation. It's your own fault you lost all your money, and it's and it's basically your fault she's angry at you. Well, if we win the witch's skirt, what the hell are you going to give us as a reward? I mean, you're broke. And I don't really think you've got anything that we would really want then. Right, quest updated. Rowenni is not allowed to play the lottery. Nevertheless, he's desperate to win the witch's skirt for his wife. The item is a category S prize and he needs help to win it. Well, that's not very good, because technically if we win it, we're the one that's using our money for it. Boy. No, I haven't actually won it yet, so the day's about to change over where we'll get another turn on it anyway, so let's see. Nitaiwa. Yes we have, he's a bit of an idiot. Well, how can he be a fine man if you blow all your money away? New side quest, the fish 3 received. Well, that's the thing, you're playing on a chance, really. And that tends to be what happens, you end up broke more than anything. Ooh. I haven't really fished in this area before. A modest reward? In other words, that just means whatever junk you've got lying around. I don't think I've got any of them. The purling pond, okay. So, quest updated again. If you would like to help Nitaiwa catch 5 sea foxes from the purling pond, fair enough, I guess that's why I've got a new fishing rod in this area. Let's see, so the purling pond is over there, so I can definitely spend a bit of time off camera trying to capture them as well. Okay, so while I was off camera, I did go ahead and killed off this enemy that was in front of this guy here. So let's talk to him. Ronjo. Okay. Is that it? I thought our main quest was to try and find... Well, shouldn't that really have updated then? Because it does say ask around for clues and how to find them. And you've just told me he's in there. But I don't have the key for in there. So, let's see. Oops. Pressing all the wrong buttons right now. Okay, so let's see what we've actually got here. So, we've got the fish 3 where we have to catch 5 sea foxes. We've got the gambler where we've got to get the witch's skirt for Rowenni. And we've got to find the ooze worm in the Osher Swamp. For the ogre. We've got to help Grandma Tangjing to retrieve some rare glowing masks and Mokimfu's wisdom, and we've still got to get 12 roots. I've actually got the scraps of leather just now, so I'll have to probably spend a bit of time trying to find them. Find all the treasures hidden on the Wonder Keys, return to Canelli. Actually, off camera, as I've said before, I basically completed all these sections. There was a couple of treasure chests on some of these little islands. There's one treasure chest I've still to complete, which might actually complete that quest, but it's actually guarded by some bone princes, and they are very, very tough. So possibly if I've now got this new gear that I've just bought, if I spend a bit of time leveling up that gear, putting some new stuff into it, obviously having more defense, more speed and more HP, it might actually let me stand a chance of defeating that enemy. Plus now I've obviously got the skill that stops enemies from removing armor on me as well, so that's probably going to be a massive help too. But it is on this island here, if I remember right. I think that's all the side quests that we have to do there. I'm just going to double check in town that I haven't missed anybody to speak to. Let's see, blacksmith. Oh, there you are, there's someone I haven't spoke to. Alinja. Behave or it's off with your hands. That's kind of cruel. Is that all you've got to say? Yep, okay. Can I speak to the dog? Hello, dog. Nope, okay. Right, so we've been in there, we've talked to you, you're just the boat rental guy. We've got all our new items. Let's... Oh, I've actually not been in the Monster Hunt Arena yet. Just in case there's anything in there that we've to grab. I don't think we can ever talk to any of these people. Let's go down this way. Oh, there's a bag. 175 rainbow coins. Let's see. I'm doing pretty well. On Franca, because it's now at level 85. Obviously, I still need to try and get to level 100. So we're getting there slowly but surely. That's fine, but I'll keep that happening just now. Actually, I just want to double check that side quest for that, to be honest with you. I can remember where it is. We've still got to do that friendly fight thing for Kafar. And we need to go back to Kintaro and deal with that as well. Still need to go back to that old lady. I think she's in Rock Solid and do the 25 treasure chest. I'm not sure if I've done 25 just yet. We've not hit over 500,000 damage either yet. Ah, that's it there. Field Studies 3. Paley would like you to study a mushroom egg to level 100 or higher. So that's in Loose Rock. That's fine. So that's the one I'm still working on as well. Other than that, I think that's about it there. Let's just look around. Okay, so there is a treasure chest. Let's open it. So we've got 20 yellow skill stones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 health tonics. So we'll take all them. They're definitely going to be going to Ashley. Okay, food bags full. We'll give these to Ashley. Okay, take the other three. Four, sorry. Take them. Do the same again. Basically just going to keep giving them to Ashley. Everybody else seems to be leveling up pretty good, bar her, but that at least gives her another 1000 HP there. Speed buffs, I'll get, let's see, forgot I actually had small strength tonics. I'll probably give them to Lane, just so that he's now getting close to 700 on everything. That should be enough for there. Trial battles, I've still obviously got to do the protective magic for expert for them. It'll probably be a while before I can do the master levels for everybody, but we'll get there. Let's come out of here then. Seems like that's all that was in there. Alright, so let's see. So we've done all that. I still need to go up around and start collecting more roots and stuff like that for some of these quests. I'm probably going to spend a bit of time doing up my new armour. Well, okay, it's a new day. We can actually try and see if we can win that witch's skirt for that Rowenni guy. Okay, let's try it. I'm not even sure if we're at the right bet level in order to win it. We got a B prize. Right, what have we won? A yellow crystal. To be honest, I'd rather have red crystals. I need kind of more of them. Let's keep going. We've got another two turns after this. We got another B prize. Okay. What's it this time? Equipment license 5. It's not too bad, but obviously I'm not really using beasts at the moment. Okay. Let's do another 200. We've got one more turn after this. Make it at least an S or an A prize, come on. Ugh. Right, it seems like Mighty Flask is what we've won because it's flashing on the screen. And it is. Right, you've got one more chance. Give me an S rank prize, please. Come on. I know you've got it in you. Give me the Witch's Skirt. Ah, we're not even anywhere near it. And another B prize. We've got another yellow crystal. Ah, well. So, we'll just take that.
Thank you.
Okay, so let's see. I think that's everything done now in this village. So we've still got this flashing icon over here. We've got a couple of stuff over here to do. I might actually have to go off camera, try and fish up some of these things. I want to do it very quickly, actually. I'm just going to very quickly jump over here to this pond, so I can equip. Oh, seems like that's the spot. I can probably put on the new fishing rod. I've actually been doing a lot of fishing off camera. As you can see, I'm now at level 99, which it seems like it doesn't go any further than that. So, fortunately, I've only got grey sharks. See if we can actually find some of these sea foxes. Actually, fishing's a really good way of actually, you know, making a lot of money. I just like seeing all the little ducks in the water. They're doing absolutely nothing, just floating on top, minding their own business while I'm fishing away. Yeah. I might actually have to spend a bit of time fishing as well, just to try and make some additional money. It's not a deal. That's not a good one. That's not what we're looking for. Give it one more go, and if it's not that, then we're going to have to end it for today, because I do need to head out. Ah, it's another grey shark. Ah, well. I gave it a go. Yeah. Alright. Okay guys, so what I feel like I'm going to do is leave it here for today. I am going to go off camera. When I come back, I'm going to go off camera and try and fish up some of these sea foxes that we need for that quest. I'm going to obviously keep looking around as well and get more of those roots so we can go back and there was a little house, I think it's over here, and try and get ready so we can turn in these roots and scraps of leather for that quest. And what I'll do also is the new gear that we've just bought, I'll equip everything on, and I'm going to spend a bit of time battling and trying to level up that gear, so that way then we'll continue on. In the next episode, obviously what we'll do is head over to this flashing icon. If it is going to be another battle, get ourselves prepared and we'll take on that battle. But until then guys, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again next time.